Martin Jaenke was just 11 when he built a magic invention for the time, a crystal radio. He could not have imagined that nearly half a century later, from his early interest in electronics, his knowledge would add to the efforts to put Americans on the moon. Jaenke's early education was in a one-room schoolhouse in Germany. He wouldn't stay but 2 or 3 years. His father, a Lutheran clergyman, took over tutoring, and for high school, sent the boy to a 400-year-old institution that taught a classical education. During World War II, Jaenke worked in private industry, developing remote controls for ground-to-air defense rockets. He even visited the secret Peenemünde rocket facility to demonstrate rocket technology to Luftwaffe head Hermann Göring. Post-World War II Germany didn't offer much in the way of work, even for someone such as Dr. Martin Jaenke, who had degrees in electronics. So, he moved his family to the countryside and opened a radio and typewriter repair shop. In the cities, hunger was rampant. But in the countryside, the Jaenkes survived on their garden and livestock. Jaenke's political activity, however, as founder of the Christian Democrats and town burgermeister, got him notice. The wrong kind. In 1949, he fled East Germany and escaped on the Berlin Airlift. His wife, Eve, and children hoped to join him soon. Eve twice slipped through the Iron Curtain to visit her parents in Berlin. Her father had been a physician who retired early rather than participate in Adolf Hitler's euthanizing those the Führer considered undesirable. Eve had wanted to study medicine and surgery, but she said Hitler recalled all females from the medical school, allowing only men to attend. On Eve's second return trip from Berlin, the Russians captured her. She was locked in a cellar with other prisoners. Her presents of oranges and shoes for her children were confiscated, as was a letter from her father. When she refused to translate the letter, she was roughed up a bit. Eve was eventually released. She rushed home, gathered up the children, and grabbed the train to Berlin. She called the situation Cloak and Dagger. The Berlin Airlift took them to a reunion with Martin. By then, he had found work developing radio telephone systems for vehicles and a system to dial long distance without an operator. In 1953, Dr. Ernst Steinhoff, who had developed guidance for Germany's V-2 weapon and who had immigrated to the United States under Operation Paperclip, urged the Jaenkes to come to the U.S. and Holloman Air Force Base in Alamogordo, New Mexico. Steinhoff and Jaenke had been wartime colleagues. Getting approval was difficult, but Jaenke endured numerous interviews and even a polygraph. Finally, the family was placed aboard a troop transport, arriving in New York on Eve's birthday after 10 days at sea. The Statue of Liberty greeted them. A train brought them to Alamogordo, where Jaenke worked on missile guidance and computers at Holloman. His many positions included Chief Project Analyst at the Holloman Test Track Central Inertial Guidance Test Facility. The International Space Hall of Fame inducted Martin Jaenke in 1993. Jaenke died April 20, 2001, and Eve several years afterward. The Jaenkes became U.S. citizens in 1958. In 1969, the Daughters of the American Revolution presented Eve with the Americanism Medal, the first naturalized citizen to be so honored.